Ransomware attacks. Attacks where a system is shut down and paralyzed until it is paid. We have seen this happen in cities across the country, from Atlanta to Baltimore and a hospital system in Los Angeles.
And you've mentioned those that have gotten high profile. What you've not mentioned are the literally dozens, if not hundreds, of mid-sized and smaller hospital systems and smaller communities that have quietly paid the ransomware without any public notice. This is an epidemic.
So are elections going to be vulnerable to this kind of attack in 2020?
I think there were a number of local election officials after 2016 that really questioned whether the Russians had intervened in their states. I think there are very few naysayers now. Mm. They've seen the evidence. I think DHS made a dreadful mistake in the immediate aftermath of 2016, that it took them almost a year to reveal how many states were actually attacked, because virtually every state was attacked. And I think, again, we're better, but I can't give you the assurance that we will be totally safe in 2020. That's why we ought to pass this bipartisan legislation. Yeah. That's why the relatively small amount of additional federal money to go into protecting the integrity of our system should take place.